When you mention the name Carrie Strug to me, the words that come up are hero, courageous, and someone who never gave up.
Carrie Strug was born in 1977 in Tucson, Arizona. And not long from the time she was able to walk did Carrie decide she wanted to be a gymnast, just like her older sister, Lisa.
Carrie was upside down more than she was right side up. And you know, we'd always say Carrie, because she was always standing on her hands.
We'd be walking along the street and there'd be a curb, and she would get up on the curb and start to walk like she was on a balance beam.
By the time Strug was 4 years old, she was doing flips and somersaults. And then, in 1984, Carrie was captivated by a performance at the Olympic Games in Los Angeles.
Yes. There it is.
She did it.
10, the gold medal. The gold medal goes to Mary Lou Retton.
A year later, at age 8, Carrie competed in her first meet. She quickly established herself as a talent with unlimited potential. And in 1991, at 13 years old, Strug became the youngest female to win an event at the USA Gymnastics Championships, claiming the vault title. Then, the following year, Carrie was the youngest Olympian at the 1992 Olympics in Barcelona, Spain, where she won a team bronze medal.
She was young, driven, talented, and very competitive.
In 1996, Carrie continued to excel, taking the all-around title at the American Cup. Then she won the floor exercise and vault at the U.S. Olympic Trials and finished second in the all-around. That performance placed Carrie on her second Olympic team, a team dubbed the Magnificent Seven. With hopes of winning the United States a team gold medal for the first time ever at the Games in Atlanta.
No one else is competing. All eyes on Carrie.
She anchored this team after the first day of competition, posting the highest score. She has done her job again.
With Carrie as one of the team's leaders, the U.S. had a commanding lead over Russia heading into the final rotation. But during the last event, the vault, the first five Americans failed to cleanly stick their landing. It appeared for the United States to win the gold medal. Carrie Strug, the team's anchor, in her best event, would have to deliver the performance of her life.
Oh! Three falls in a row for the Americans.
A shock in the entire crowd, but across our team was just, I mean, what in the world? We are on top and we're gonna lose it right now.
And I saw Bella kind of walking down off of the platform, but walking with her, and he's going, okay, Carrie, shake it off, be tough. And I had no doubt in my mind that she would go back down there, salute to the judge, and do that second vault.
Carrie Strug is hurt. She is hurt badly. She hurt herself on the first vault. Probably the last thing she should have done was vault again, but she did, and now she is in a lot of pain. A 9.712, she has done it! Carrie Strug has won the gold medal for the United States team.
Afterwards, having torn two ligaments in her left ankle and unable to walk, Carrie's coach Bella Carolla carried Strug to the medal stand so she could be with her team, an indelible image that will forever live in Olympic lore.
To combine the bravery with a great athletic performance, and that moment, which was hanging in there, we're gonna be the first time ever in the position of the gold, or we are losing the gold. Yes, that moment gonna really hard to recreate.
Carrie's vault to help the gymnastics team win the gold medal in 96, in my mind, in my opinion, ranks up there with the 1980 hockey team. There are those moments that you will never, ever forget.